Good afternoon, dear children. So here let us start with a new chapter, that is, Where is my mother? So now here let us see that who is asking this question and why. So here it goes. Once in Assam, a herd of wild elephants left the sanctuary and entered the paddy fields in a nearby village looking for food. So this story is taking place in the eastern India, that is the state of Assam, and there we see a herd of wild elephants. So these elephants, they were living in jungle, and so they are called as wild elephants, and they move in a group, and so they are called as herd of elephants. Okay, so that is the collective noun for elephants. Left the sanctuary. Sanctuary means the place where these wild animals are kept. And entered the paddy fields. So paddy fields means the rice fields. In a nearby village looking for food. The villagers drove them away from their fields with lighted torches and loud cries. Lighted torches means the burning wood. Okay, so that is also known as the lighted torch. That is normally used in these areas. In the panic and confusion, a baby elephant fell into a pit and was left behind. Panic means out of fear. So, and confused that what to do, where they were running. So, then a baby elephant fell into a pit. Pit means a hole. And was left behind. So, that means the other elephants moved ahead. And this elephant was left behind. Nalia, a greedy villager, found the baby and decided to sell it off. Read how three friends, Dhanai, Babul and Jaunty, rescued the baby elephant and helped it get back to its mother. So here we go with the story. On reaching Nalia's house, Dhanai, Babul and Jaunty stopped to take a look around. So here Nalia had taken the baby elephant to his home and he had tied it up. And so now here quietly these three friends, Dhanai, Babul and Jaunty, had gone there quietly to take a look at this baby elephant. The house was in total darkness, so that means it's night time. They entered the compound from the side over the bamboo fencing, taking care not to make the slightest sound. Bamboo fencing means the boundary was not made of any wall, but rather it was fenced with bamboo. So they did not make any sound. They circled the house, reached the cow shed at the back. So there was a cow shed, and so they moved at the back of that house to inside that cow shed and stopped suddenly. Dismay writ large on their faces. So what do you mean by this? So that means dismay means a worried look was there on their faces when they entered the cow shed. Now, why was there this worried look on their faces? Let's find out. One of Nalia's thugs sat by the open entrance to the cow shed with his back against the wall. Thugs means like a big figure person, and that person acts as the bodyguard actually. Hefty figure, very big. Tall and very fat also. These are very strong people and they act as the bodyguard. So he was sitting by the entrance to the cow shed with his back against the wall. So that means this thug could not see the boys. The boys could not see the man clearly in the dim light. Dim light means the little light that was there. But they heard a snore. Snore means karate lena, that is what you call in Hindi. Nalia's guard was asleep. So Nalia had posted a guard to keep watch over his treasure. So now they understood. So that means there is a guard to look after this treasure. And what was this treasure? A baby elephant. Because if Nalia would sell this baby elephant, then he would get a lot of money. With extreme caution, so that means very carefully, the boys slipped past the guard into the cowshed. Jaunty switched on his torch and probed the interior. So now they were carrying a torch along with them and then they switched on the torch to look inside the cowshed, which was dark. Probed means to look inside carefully, okay, or to search. On the left side of the shed sat two massive bulls. Massive means huge. Bulls with a pile of hay in front of them. So these bulls are very strong and they also act as guards. And they were sitting with a pile of hay. Pile means hay ka pura dher tha. So that it was in front of these bulls, they were eating them. The bulls were chewing the hay and showed no reaction to the sudden appearance of the boys. In the extreme right hand corner, the elephant calf was tied to a stout bamboo pole. Stout means strong. Okay. So this calf was tied to the strong bamboo pole. Its fore and hind limbs were hobbled with ropes. So that means it was tied with ropes. Fore limbs means the front legs and the hind limbs means the back legs. And the rope around its neck was tied to the pole. It made no sign that it was aware of the three boys either. They threw the torch beam on the baby's face. So torch beam means the torch light on the baby's face. The three youngsters almost exclaimed aloud, exclaimed with surprise, okay, when they saw the baby elephant. The baby was crying softly. A stream of tears was pouring down its face. The boys tiptoed up to the elephant calf and gently stroked its back. Stroke means to put a hand over the back of the elephant lovingly. Babul wiped its tears with the end of his shirt. The calf responded by curling its trunk around the boy in a gesture of affection. So when these boys gave some affection or love, so immediately the calf understood, and so the calf also turned towards these three boys and curling its trunk around the boy. From the belt around its waist, Jaunty brought out a curved knife with a wooden handle. Such knives used to chop betel nut. Betel means, you say that paan ka patta hota hai, so that is, and in that you have that supari, so that is known as your betel nut. Okay, so with that, this type of knife, they chop those betel nuts. So that he was carrying. So such knives used to chop betel nut are common in every household in the region. Dhanai was armed with a similar knife too. Together they hacked at the loops of the ropes to give the cut ends a frayed look. So both of them cut the rope, and so they cut in such a way so that it has a tattered or the ragged look. Means frayed look. So that means what it should be shown that no one has cut it with a knife, rather the elephant tried to cut it around something, and so then it got the rope has cut. So that is a frayed look. To have cut the rope cleanly would have given the game away. So if it would be cut cleanly and it would be clear, then to this Nalia that someone had come and cut the rope. They wanted to give the impression that the baby had succeeded in snapping its fetters. So now they wanted to give the impression that the baby itself, this baby elephant, tried to snap it by pulling and struggling, and then this rope got snapped off and had escaped without any outside help. Strangely enough, the elephant calf offered no resistance. No resistance means it did not try to protest against these boys. It was also sitting quietly, and these boys were doing this fraying of the rope. It was as if it had sensed that the boys were there to help. So it seemed as though the baby elephant understood that these boys had come to help it. Babul kept stroking its back. Stroking means to put a hand and lovingly, caringly you stroke it. Strike the back. So that the baby elephant would be feeling that affectionate feeling it would get. stroking its back to soothe it to comfort it. Just then, one of the bulls, which had so far taken no interest in the proceedings, let out a loud bellow, means a loud sound. Outside, the guard woke up, muttered something and jumped to his feet. So now because of that buffalo's sound, this guard also, the thug also woke up. So that means these two buffaloes are actually kept to guard the baby elephant. The boys were totally exposed. So now the boys came in front of the thug. The empty shed offered no cover. So they could not hide themselves because there was no place to hide. Set the baby free. And why there was no place to hide in the shed? Because it was totally empty. So now here, what they have to do? Set the baby free, Jaunty said in a nervous whisper. He is our only chance. So now quickly you have to set the baby free. And so that way only they can free the baby elephant, as well as they themselves will have to escape. With a startled cry, startled means surprised cry, the elephant calf shot off like an express train. So now immediately as the ropes were snapped off, the baby elephant also shooted out, and like an express train it ran out from the cowshed. It ran through the door and dashed straight into the guard, pushing him aside. The man, not quite sure what had hit him, let out a yell of alarm as he fell. He was, however, not hurt and was up in a second, dashing after the fleeing baby. Fleeing means running. Okay. So the thug himself, he was pushed by the baby elephant and he could not understand what to do. He just stood up and ran after the baby elephant. The calf ran straight towards the gate. Finding it closed, it ran along the fencing that surrounded the compound. So then it moved towards the compound now. The boys, finding the guard fully occupied with the escaping animal, lost no time. So now here the boys saw that the guard was totally only after the baby elephant. So this was their chance to run away from there to escape. They were out of the shed like lightning, means as quick as lightning. They cut across the empty backyard to the fence on their left. The harried guard, harried means here the troubled, harassed. He was totally harassed. He did not understand what to do. He was totally troubled. Guard was yelling. Yelling means shouting his head off. The three boys scaled. Scaled means climbed the fence in one swift movement and ran to the gate. They waited under cover just outside the gate and watched the fun. The elephant calf was leading the man on a merry chase. So now they are enjoying how the baby elephant, the elephant calf was running, and behind the calf the thug was also running. And they were sure that their thug could not catch the baby elephant. Escaped, escaped, the guard shouted as he ran. The elephant calf has escaped. Someone lit a lantern within the hut and the front door burst open. Nalia and two others rushed out and joined in the furious chase. So now two more men along with Nalia had come out. Round and round the baby went with the men in hot pursuit. Hot pursuit means they are running after him. The walls of the hut were weak, being made of spliced bamboo. So these huts are made of bamboo, which is suitable for the rainy season, but it is not suitable for such type of great force as the baby elephant was giving. The elephant calf did not know its own strength. It crashed straight into the wall, went through it as if it were made of paper, crashed through a couple of inner walls, hit the outer wall on the opposite side and rushed out of the house. So this way here now it has escaped. Get the kunki, the trained elephants, Nalia barked. So now here Nalia is shouting that come on, go and get the kunki. Now who is a kunki? Kunki is a trained elephant who are supposed to bring the other elephants back to their master. Okay, so a baby elephant could be brought only by a Kunki and no one else could have caught the baby elephant. We will have to rope the calf, means catch the calf. We must do something, Babul said urgently. So now here the three boys, they are also thinking of an idea how the baby elephant should come out of that compound. We must do something, Babul said urgently. If they bring the Kunki, which they should have done in the first place, the calf doesn't stand a chance. So if a Kunki comes, then the calf won't be able to escape. So that means our first work is to do something so that the Kunki does not come here before the baby elephant escapes. Come, said Dhanai. I know a trick that might work. Dhanai put two fingers to his mouth and let out a piercing whistle. This was a trick his father had taught him. The effect of the whistle on the baby elephant was electric. So now here he blew a whistle and that whistle was very much in force. Okay. And so that was very effective now. With great speed, it took off in the direction from which the whistle had come. So the baby elephant ran towards the sound of the whistle. It raced to the place where its three friends waited. The boys gave it a hurried but affectionate welcome. So that means they embraced the baby elephant quickly and then they all started moving. Then Babul and Dhanai led the baby elephant further into the sanctuary. So now the boys thought that once the baby elephant gets into the sanctuary, then it is saved. So for that, Babul and Dhanai, they led this baby elephant towards the sanctuary while Jaunty stayed back to set up a trap for Nalia and his men. So Jaunty was there to trap Nalia and his men. Dhanai and Babul with the baby elephant in tow means behind them, had set a smart pace, means very quick movement they were moving. But they had to slow down further ahead to find out the location of the mother elephant. So they did not know where the mother elephant would be there in the sanctuary. As if to help them, the mother let out a trumpet which sounded loud and clear. So just then the mother elephant also as though felt what these boys were having the trouble of. So that time the mother elephant let out a sound, a trumpet sound. The baby recognized her call. So of course every baby understands the mother's voice. And so now the baby elephant could hear and understand the mother's voice. And so immediately it also responded with its own sound, own call. With a joyous squeal, it broke loose from the boys and rushed towards its mother across the open ground. So now the baby elephant understood where its mother must be. And so it started running towards its mother in that direction. The mother saw her calf and expressed her delight with furious trumpets. So mother also could see the baby and immediately she was also very happy and she gave a trumpet. The baby was safe now. The mother would protect it and Nalia would be in for a surprise. So Nalia had never thought that in this way the baby elephant would be caught. So that is what the children were thinking. Yes, now Nalia is in a surprise that what happened to the baby elephant. So who is the author of the story? Arup Kumar Datta. Okay. So children, it's a very easy chapter. Hope you all have understood. So please read the chapter thoroughly and then you will understand. You have to remember the events one after the other, the names of the characters of the story. So these are very important. So please read the chapter thoroughly. Okay. So thank you and have a wonderful day.